Hello students, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I'm Dr. Savita. Today we are going to discuss about the module Indian Architecture, Ancient, Medieval and Modern from the paper Tourism Products of India. After completing this module, the students will be able to understand the meaning and concept of Indian architecture, understand the ancient, medieval and modern architecture, and also know about the concept of Hindu temples. What is architecture? The word architecture comes from the Latin word architectura, chief builder, means the process and the product of planning, designing and constructing buildings and other physical structures. Architecture may also define in this way that any man-made building or structure like a tower or monument, a man-made building or structure that is important, large or highly creative, a carefully designed object, a design for a large area such as a city, town, park or landscape, the art or science of designing and building buildings, structures, objects and outdoor spaces, a building style, method or process, a plan for organizing space, elegant building, engineering, the plan design of any kind of system with environmental care and geographical knowledge. The architecture can be classified into two types: natural architecture like caves, shelters where the prehistoric human left their imprints, and the artificial or human created architecture. For more easy understanding, architecture of human created may classified in three groups: domestic architecture, religious architecture and administrative or public purposes architecture. Art as a part and parcel of everybody's life is easy to understand. The Indian tradition and manifested in Vedic literary texts such as the Vedas, the Upanishads, the epics, the Puranas, the Agamas and the Shilp Pashtras, as well as in folk and local practices, oral literature and the classics and the Hindu, Buddhist and Jain literatures. Architecture of India. The Indian architecture till pre-modern period is basically religious and spiritual and not merely art for art's sake. Art in India include architecture because most of the work of art are architectural member of some temple or shrine, caves, pillars and rock walls. Though the beginning of architecture in India reported since prehistoric times as from Paisaramunger district, Bihar, but in established form it was started during Harappa times and from Gilanth, a Chalcolithic state, Indus Saraswati Valley civilization. This period, Harappa, Dholavira, Kalibanga, Surkodda, Lothal, Rakhigiri and Mohenjo-daro being main centers, is noted for its sites built of sandrig bricks, for its cities built of sun-dried bricks, fired bricks, rough stone and dressed stone, roadside drainage system and fortified walls, multi-storied houses and big buildings for some public, royal or religious purposes like assembly halls, granaries, probably temples, etc. The baths and toilets and drainage system were in very advanced stage. The grid layout planning of the cities with roads at exact right angles is the modern system that was implemented in the city of this particular civilization. Maurya period. The architecture of Mauryan period can be classified into five groups: monolithic pillars, rock cut cave, rock cut sculptures, building made of wooden, stone and brick, defense walls, spouts. Among these, the pillars and rock cut caves are still in attraction of mankind. The eight caves with the walls bearing typical Mauryan polish at Barabar and Nandarjuni in Gaya district of Bihar were carved by Ashoka and his grandson Darshartha. Mauryan palace at Bulandibagh at Pataliputra made of wood and a pavilion with sandstone pillars at Kumrahar are worth to notice. The rock cut caves at Kerala are worth to notice. The earliest architectures were in the form of huts, round and rectangular in shape and made of bamboos. With the development of kingship, the palaces took place, which were huge in size and sometimes multi-storied too. So the bamboos were replaced by hardwood to give it proper shape. The palace is called Prasada. Hence, the temple is often called the same as denoted it as the palace of God. The mixed shape of Kutangshala is named as Gaja Parishathar, elephant back shape. This was a common shape in Mauryan period, with the construction material being stone or brick instead of wood. Among the architectural edifices, stupas are most important and probably most ancient too, which were made as replacement of the Buddha himself. Through Jainas also built stupas. A stupa has different parts like Andha, Vedika, Harmika, Yashti, Chhatra, etc. Saputas are a sepulchral monuments, that is burial, in which ashes of cremated body were buried. Hence, these are also called Chaityas, because these were raised at the place where the dead bodies were cremated. On Chita, the pile wood, the Chaitya is a structure with a stoop at the end and a series of columns started from near the entrance and passing behind the stupa and returning up to the entrance. This can be compared with the plan of Christian church, where it is called nave. The Dharamrajika and Damekha stoops in Sarnath and Dharamrajika stoop in Taxila, Pakistan were built in this period and further developed till Gupta period. Shunga Satvahana period. The Shunga Satvahana architecture were mostly Buddhist in nature. The earliest example comes from Bharhat in Madhya Pradesh, where a large stoop made of bricks and with railing and gateway of sandstone existed in 2nd century BCE. Others were Mahastupa and many smaller stupa at Sanchi, a rock-cut monastery at Pitalkhora and Jain monasteries at Udaygiri, Khandagiri and Mathura. Railing of Bodh Gaya, Sarnath, Sanchi, Sadhara are quite interesting. Gupta period. In the history of ancient India, the Gupta's period and Gupta's empire is known as the Golden Age due to artistic accomplishment, literatures, special school of art such as at Sarnath and the evolution of temple architecture. The Guptas were the first architects of purpose-built Vedic, Puranic, Jainism and Buddhist temple in the form of rock-cut caves as at Rajgir, Udaygiri, rock-cut sculptures as at Sultanganj, Bihar temples as at Sanchi, Deogar, Sirpur, etc. Nevertheless, the influence of Gupta era building on later Indian temple architecture is indisputable and continued right through to the medieval period. The Gupta artistic style were influenced by Kushna, Mathura and Gandhara and borrowed the common feature of T-shaped doorways, decorated door jambs, sculpted panel with high relief figures and laurel wreath and acanthus motifs. During Gupta era, the rock-cut architecture reached its zenith and this era marked the beginning of the freestanding temple architecture. Post-Gupta period, the Rashtrakutas made to construct the wonderful rock-cut temples at Ellora and Elephanta. The Ellora temple has all the architectural parts of a temple like Gopuram, Nandi, Mandapam, Mahesh Mandalapam, Gardriha, etc. The Elephanta caves were made in second half of 8th century CE with superb gigantic image of Trinurti. The art still remains serene, spiritual and excellent in balance, poise and gaiety since Gupta period. The Pallavas of Vengi under Mahamala constructed rock-cut temple of Mahabalipuram or Mamallapuram. The Pallavas made to construct three types of monuments. Rock-cut Rath temple standing free, for example, Dharmaraja Ratha at Mahabalipuram. Another one, the Draupadi Ratha, has its roof carved as a thatched hut. The second type is Mandapa or rock-cut caves, for example, Adivaraha cave. The third type is Tirtham or open air carving on the face of a rock at Mahabalipuram. The Chalukyas of Badami made to construct temples in Karnataka in Vezar or Chalukya style, the main being that of Aihole, Badami and Patadakkal. Badami and Aihole have cave temples also with sanctum cut deep into rock. In Rajasthan, the Marugurjara temple architecture show the deep understanding of structures and refined skills of Raja's Thani Craftsman with two prominent styles, Mahamaru and Maru Gurjara. Mahamaru style dwelt primarily in Marudesa, Sapdalaksha, Surasena and parts of Upparmala, whereas Maru Gurjara originated in Medhappa, Gurjara Desa, Arbudha, Gurjara Desa, Anartha and some areas of Gujarat. In both of these styles, architecture is treated sculpturally. There are many vavs in Gujarat, Rani Ki Vav being most important, made in 11th century CE in Maru Gurjara style. It shows stepped well, giving it a shape of inverted temple. Post-Gupta period phase 2. After Guptas, the Vardhanas dynasty started to rule in North India. The great work of architecture were produced in their regime, like brick temple of Lakshmana in Sirpur, Chhattisgarh, and temple number 18 at Sanchi. After him, the Gurjara Pratiharas came to power, Nagabhata and Meher Bhoja being most important. In South India, the Pallavas were succeeded by the Cholas in Tamil Nadu. The two temples of highest scale of Chola architecture are that of Brihadishwara temple at Tanjore and Gangai Kondachulapuram near Kambeknam. The Brihadishwara temple is marked with a huge and tall vimana, 13 diminishing stores over the Garbhagriha, while the later one has smaller vimana and Gopuraman, the four gateways. Early medieval period, the Hoyasalas, contemporary to late Pallas and early post Cholas, developed their own characteristic style of art and architecture between the 11th and the 14th centuries. Large and small temples built during this era remain as temples of Hoyasala architectural style, including the Chaneshwar temple at Vellore, the Hoyasalavara temple at Halebidu and Kesava temple at Somnath Putra. Under the example of fine Hoyasala craftsmanship are the temples at Belavadi, Amritpura and Nugehali. The Hoyasala architectural style shows a negligible Indo-Aryan influence, while the impact of Southern India style is more distinct. The Odissean school of art and architecture is another outstanding style in itself. The Parshurameshwara, Mukteshwara, Lingraja, Raja Rani and Surya temples of Konark are remarkable examples of this style. These intricately carved temples show gradual development of Nagara style of architecture from the simple Shikara on the Garbhagriha of Parshurameshwara temple to additional front Mandapa of Rajarani temple to further chariot of 12 wheels run by 7 horses and a separate Natte Mangappa in Sun Temple in Konark. The emphasis was given to the monumentality, largeness and expansiveness, leading to the birth of temple complexes. The Jageshwara group of 124 temples, Bageshwara group and many other temples of Uttarakhand were manufactured with different styles called Himalayan style, comprising five styles named as Rekhalatina, Famsana, flat roofed, pyramidal and mixture of all four. These were constructed and reconstructed in between 18th to 13th century CE. The Chandelas in Khajuraho of Madhya Pradesh got to construct about 30 temples of Shiva, Vishnu and Jinas in a period of 100 years. The Kendriya Mahadeva temple among these is masterpiece in quality of architecture and quantity of sculptures. The medieval period of ancient North India had produced Sun temple at Modhra in Gujarat, Udheshwara temple near Gwalior, Vimal, Tejapal and Vastupala temple of Jainas at Mount Abu. Jayastambha and Kirti Stambha of the Jainas at Chittor in Rajasthan are famous examples. In South India, the Vijayanagara monuments of Hampi, Naika temple of Srirangapatnam and Meenakshi temple of Madurai are important temples for their architecture and their elaborate sculptures. Vijayanagara architecture of the period was a notable building style with a combination of Chalukya, Hosala, Pandya and Chola styles and is characterized by a return to the simplistic and serene art of the past concept of Hindu temples. The Hindu temples are the house of God and the place of worship at the same time. It is monument of manifestation. It represents the things of which the cosmic word Brahmada or whole universe is composed of. This is the reason that the walls of a Hindu temple are decorated with the figures of gods, goddesses, semi-divine, mythical being, human beings, flora and fauna, water bodies and its creature, mountains, villages, forts, huts, houses, palaces and every worldly thing. It even has intimate scenes. The architecture of Hindu temple differs according to the difference of vision, but only in forms. A Hindu temple is also compared with Vastu Purushai, an architectural piece resembling the body of a human body or god or supreme being. So different parts of temple represent different parts of a human body like Pad, Pitha, Jang, Karnas, Hirsha, Skanda, etc. The different parts of temple are decorated with different pattern like Purnagata, Apsara, Yaksha, Yakshini, Padma, Amalka, floral pattern, etc. The style of temple architecture are mainly three. Nagara is four-sided with a square Garbhagrihas. The earliest temple of this style are that of Sanchi in Madhya Pradesh and Vishnu's temple of Deoghar near Jhansi, Uttar Pradesh. Dravida are also called Vimana, meaning ship or boat. It has six main parts: Gopuram, enclosed walls, Bhog Mandapa, Neti Mandapa, the topmost story was replaced by Lachana or Vahana or Mount of Goats to whom the temple was dedicated, like a bull or bhoot or Shia temples, and a Garuda or eagle on Vishnu's temple. Visara and Bisara of north and south style was used in constructing temples lying between Vindhyas and river Krishna. For example, the temples of Halibindu, Belur, Somnath Putra and Pataldhakal. Though there are many other styles developed from these styles according to the local traditions, demands or artisans imaginations and skills, like the Orisans. The Orisan Shikaras type temples are called Rekhadwal, etymologically curvilinear temple, because the Shikara here is slightly curvilinear. The porch of the Mandapa, on the other hand, is called Pidadul, etymologically flat seat temple, because its roof is like a stepped pyramid with a series of flat platforms placed one over the other in diminishing dimensions. Early modern period, Indo-Islamic architecture. The architecture during the Mughal period, with its rulers being of Turco-Mongol origin, has shown a notable blend of Indian style combined with the Islamic. The architecture of this time are classified into five groups: mosque, minars, fort, tomb, bridge, sarai, open big doors, walls, etc. Mughal tombs of sandstone and marble show Persian influence. The Red Fort at Agra and the walled city of Fatehpur Sikri are among the architectural achievements of this time, as is the Taj Mahal, built as a tomb for Queen Mumtaz Mahal by Shah Jahan. The Taj Mahal does contain tilework of plant ornaments. Humayun's tomb of Mughal Emperor Humayun in Delhi was commissioned by his wife Bega Begum in 1569-70. Safdarganj's tomb, a sandstone and marble mausoleum, the Ajmer Fort with Jaigarh Fort in Rajasthan are beautifully and lavishly constructed, with all arrangements of comfort and safety for the royal families. The Ranthambore National Park has also a fort with a temple of Ganesh on the hilltop. Maratha architecture. The Marathas ruled over most of Maharashtra from the mid-17th to the early 19th. Their religious activity took full shape, and soon the skylines of Maharashtrian town were dominated by rising temple spires of Hindu architecture. There are very little material regarding the architecture of earlier period covering the regime of Shivaji, Sambhaji, Rajaram and Shahu. However, we can get some idea about the characteristic of the Maratha style from later buildings such as forts, palaces and temples. Brick, wood, mortar and stone were the material used for construction. Besides other apartments, the palaces contained darbar halls and ranga and chitra mandirs. Among the temples constructed during the period, we may refer to the Vithalvadi temple near Pune and the temple of Shambhu, Mahadev Vrat, Shingara, Nagpur. These temples followed the earlier style of Yadava temples. The Marathas excelled in fort architecture. The woodwork they used to decorate their places and other civil buildings were intricate and minute. Sikh architecture is a style of architecture that is characterized with values and progressiveness, exquisite intricacy, austere beauty and logical flowing lines. Sikh architecture was distinguished for its many curves and straight lines. Shri Keshgarh Sahib and Shri Harmandir Sahib, Darbar Sahib in Punjab are prime examples. The Golden Temple is a mesmerizing blend of Hindu and Islamic architectural style with the floral pattern like that is Taj Mahal. The intricately engraved gold panels and dome gilded with 750 kg of gold is the prime attraction. European colonial architecture. As with the Mughals, under European colonial rule, architecture became an emblem of power designed to endorse the occupying power. Numerous European countries invaded India and created architectural style reflective of their ancestral and adopted homes. The European colonizers created architecture that symbolized their mission of conquest dedicated to the state or religion. British colonial era. The British colonialized cities of Madras, Calcutta, Bombay, Delhi, Agra, Bankipur, Karachi, Nagpur, Bhopal and Hyderabad. St. Andrew Kirk, Madras is known for its colonial architecture. The staple of Madras was Fort St. George, a wallet-squared building adjacent to the beach. Surrounding the fort was White Town settlement of British and Indian area, Black Town later to be called Georgetown. French. The French colonized a fishing village named Pondicherry in Tamil Nadu and transformed it into a flourishing port town on the French grid pattern, including French Quarter and the Indian Quarter. The Dutch entered India in the early 17th century and colonized Surat, Bharuch, Venerula, Ahmedabad, Malabar Coast, Kochi, Dutch palace named as Mattancherry Palace, a cemetery, David Hall, Western Bungla, Thakur Houses, and Sadras, etc. Portuguese. The Portuguese built many cathedrals, churches, basilicas, and seminaries as Basilica of Bom Jesus, Old Goa, St. Francis, Xavier Church, etc. The tiled houses with false ceiling of wood painted with bright color are noticeable. The Hajardugri Palace. The Hajardugri Palace with 1,000 doors in Murshidabad is an excellent example of Indo-European architecture with Italian style. Crawford Market, Mumbai, All Saints Cathedral, Allahabad, Moore College are other important architectural examples of modern India. The Victoria Memorial in Calcutta, large marble building, is the most effective symbolism of British Empire, built between 1906 to 21, and is a monument in tribute to Queen Victoria's reign. It is constructed in Indo-Saracenic revivalist style, a mixture of British, Mughal, Venetian, Egyptian, Deccan and Islamic styles. The Rashtrapati Bhavan with Mughal Garden in Delhi is the official home of President of India. It is constructed with Indian classical, Mughal, Sikh, Roman and European architectural elements. The Rashtrapati Nivas is located on the observatory hills of Shimla, Himachal Pradesh, residence of British Viceroy of India. The India Gate, made in triumphal arch style in 1921, is a war memorial structure, while the Gateway of India in Mumbai is made in Indo-Saracenic style in 1924. The Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus, Mumbai, is World Heritage Site and an outstanding example of Victorian Gothic Revival architecture with traditional Indian design. The Lotus Temple in Delhi, in a Baha'i house of worship in lotus flower shape. The Akshardham Temple in Delhi is a Hindu temple of Swami Narayan, constructed according to the Vastu Shastra and Panchratra Shastra. The campus of Infosys, a software company, has built in different architectural style or with their combination, like US Capitol, Washington DC, St. Paul Cathedral, London, Rashtrapati Bhavan, New Delhi, Vidha Sudha, Bangalore, Parliament House, Delhi, Colosseum, Rome, Pantheon at Acropolis, Athens, etc. There are several architectural examples still to be noted, but due to the limitation of word, these are not mentioned. So students, let's summarize what we have learned in this module. The architecture of India is rooted in its history, culture and religion. Indian architecture progressed with time and assimilated the many influences that come as a result of India's global discourse with other regions of the world throughout its millennium-old past. The architectural method practiced in India are a result of examination and implementation of its establishment, building, tradition and outside culture interactions. Growing awareness of ecology has influenced architecture in India during modern times, resulting in climate responsive architecture. Indian architecture reflects its various socio-cultural sensibilities, grandeur of construction, beautiful sculptures, delicate carving, high domes, gopuras, and extensive courtyards were the features of temple architecture in India. The architectures of ancient, medieval and modern India show the basic belief and thoughts of the respective periods. In medieval period, when Islamic religion was more powerful in India, there was concept of one God and his Peygamber Prophet Muhammad. The same was the situation in modern period when India was under British rule, and so Christianity was in more power, where there is one God and his son Jesus Christ. there is a difference between Hindu, Muslim and Christian view of architecture. For the Hindus, a temple is a house of gold, a mini cosmos. But Muslim and Christian do not think the same for a mosque or a church, which is only a place of worship or place of offering prayers to God. Thank you.